belts and Patty Melts and Monte Carlos and El Dorado. So I'm waking up out of my slumber feeling like Rollo. So follow, it's showtime at the Apollo minus the Kiki Shepherd. With about a hoe and a leopard, red hot Teddy, Pendergrass, cooler than Freddie Jackson, sipping a milkshake in a snowstorm. Left my throat warm in the dorm room at the AU. We blue hate you, athletes might take you, but you must have been mistaken with them statements that you make, huh?
What y'all know about that Outkast? Ha! What's up, y'all? What's really going on? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I hope everybody had a very Merry Christmas, and we are this close to a Happy New Year. So with that being said, this video is going to be a recap of the whole entire 2020. Before we get into the video, let me start off by saying, Mommy, Daddy, if you're watching this, excuse my language, but this has been a fucked up year, if I do say so myself. Oh my God. I thought 2016 was a bad year for us, but 2020 just took the cake for me. I cannot wait for the ball to drop, just so I can scream out Jumanji. God damn, I'm gonna have my cranberry. Absolutely. Y'all already know. Fuck 2020. Let's get into the video. First up on the list I have here that went down in 2020 was the biggest thing that happened to us, all of us, in the entire world, was the coronavirus. Coronavirus. Y'all seen that Cardi B video. A lot of people, a lot of us lost our jobs at the top of the year, including me. But fortunately, as well for a lot of us, not all of us, it didn't last long though, thank goodness, because my black ass went back to work when they called me, okay? And best believe, I was collecting and stacking up on unemployment checks in the meantime, because, you know, I heard that people kept on saying that we might go back into quarantine a second time around. I hope not. But one thing for sure, one thing that the coronavirus did do for all of us was make us sit our ass down. It did. But not really though, because after a while, a lot of y'all couldn't stand being inside of your own damn house. What is really going on? It wasn't all of y'all, you know, but some of y'all was going crazy and couldn't stand being inside your own damn house all damn day. What the hell? You couldn't wait to go back outside, go back to a club, be around a whole bunch of people, and, you know, just be around a whole bunch of people. Shut up. See, now, this is why the coronavirus is outside now, because you motherfuckers be doing the most. Okay, all that time y'all had on y'all hands being inside y'all house, y'all could understand. Y'all could have been using all that time getting y'all shit together and figuring out what it is that y'all gonna do when this shit is over with. I understand we've been in the house for months at a time, but come on now. This is why the coronavirus is outside now. But I ain't mad at y'all though. Ooh, okay, let me see. Where should I start off at? Let's see. Anyway, like I said in my previous video, creative people don't get bored. That part. Alright? But anyway, before we move on, let me read this right here. Before we move on to another thing that happened in 2020, let's take a moment of silence for all the people that we lost due to COVID. Moment of silence. All right now. R.I.P. to all those people we lost. My heart goes out to the families who lost their loved ones because of this bullshit ass virus. Speaking of those we lost in 2020, let's talk about the Black Lives Matter movement. Okay, here we go. I want to give a shout out to the black hand side, Fallen Angels. Shout out to Rayshard Brooks, Ahmaud Arbery, Breonna Taylor, George Floyd, and the list goes on and on. Say their names, and God bless all of those black folks who we lost, that lost their lives for no damn reason. But their names will live on forever. What Biggie say? You're nobody till somebody kills you? Oh, okay. He wasn't lying when he said that. Speaking of Fallen Angels, let's talk about the celebrity deaths of 2020. I don't mean to dwell on the deaths too much though, but I mean, like I said, 2020 was a fucked up year, so, okay. The celebrity deaths of 2020. Now, I had to look up the deaths of the celebrities that I was fans of myself personally. Excuse me. The deaths that hit me the most, because, you know, I don't want to forget nobody. So, yes. Of course, I got to start off with this. Kobe Bryant and Gigi Bryant. And to all the other people that was on that helicopter with them. R.I.P. You know, I remember when I was 8 years old, I had me a Kobe jersey, number 8. He was definitely one of my favorite players, you know, of all time. I remember during that time, I ain't want nothing but play ball. And Kobe was definitely my dude, man. Top of the year, 2020. We lost Kobe. R.I.P. to Kobe and to Gigi. Another person that we lost, another legend, Little Richard, the architect of rock and roll. He is. You talk about somebody being the blueprint. Little Richard, okay? Without him, it wasn't for him, we wouldn't have the Beatles, we wouldn't have Elton John, David Bowie, Prince, and the list goes on and on, okay? All right, I mean, hell, Jimi Hendrix played in his band before Jimmy made it big. Man, R.I.P. to Little Richard, okay? Oh. Another one. Oh shit. Ha! Chadwick Boseman. All I got to say is Wakanda forever. I wasn't ready for that one. That one caught me completely off guard. R.I.P. to him. He did it for us. Another one. Tiny Lister Jr. A.K.A. Debo. Damn, Debo! Natalie Denzel Reed. Best known for being in Baps with Halle Berry, hallelujah. Let me see, who else? Oh man, Naya Rivera. Man, I remember hearing about her being missing, her going missing, and I was like, oh my God, please let them find her. You know, like I was praying for her, you know. But you saved your son from drowning. You know, God bless you, Naya Rivera. You know, I remember you was that cute little girl in Family Matters. The one that had a crush on Richie. Oh, you were so cute. Oh my God. I can't believe she gone. I love Naya Rivera. I met her in person one time. She was sweet. For like 5 minutes. Anyway. to all the other fallen angels. The wrestling fan in me. You know, the wrestling fan in me. Rocky Johnson. The Rock's father, Dwayne Johnson's father, he passed away. Sean Connery, the first ever James Bond, one of my favorite James Bonds. Kelly Preston, for y'all who don't know who she is, she was in a lot of movies. She was sexy as hell too. She was John Travolta's wife. She died of breast cancer. I was surprised by her death too. Now another death that happened. Joe Clark, Lean on Me. Y'all remember Joe Clark? Morgan Freeman played him in the movie Lean on Me. The real Joe Clark, not Morgan Freeman. Joe Clark. He did. And many more. R.I.P. Okay. Moment of silence for them. R.I.P. Okay. Let's talk about the election. Let's talk about the election. Crazy enough, this was the first election that I myself voted for, crazy enough. I wish I would have voted back when Obama was in office, but you know, this is the first time I voted. And let me just say this. Donald Duck, Donald Trump, pack your shit and get the fuck out. I'm just playing. Well, maybe not. But who did y'all vote for? Leave a comment down below and tell me who y'all voted for, if y'all voted. And let me know, did anybody vote or would have voted for Kanye West? Anyway, okay. On a more lighter note, this year at the Super Bowl, we had J-Lo, Jenny from the Block, Shakira, with her hips never lying. At the Super Bowl halftime show, that was epic. Both of them was on that stage, killing it. Shakira could have got it in that damn performance. Oh my God. Y'all seen how she looked in that performance? Moving all around like that, shaking that body all around in that outfit. All that dancing going on. But that was one thing. That was one good thing that did happen in 2020. That was at the top of the year before shit got too real out here. Oof. All right. Well. Oof. Okay. Now this video seems kind of short though, but I guess that's pretty much all I have, you know, for 2020, you know what I'm saying? No, unfortunately, you know. No, I tried to find some good things to talk about and not make it all negative, you know what I'm saying? We covered the coronavirus, we talked about the Black Lives Matter movement a little bit. Everything we talked about was briefly, you know. The election. Man. The election was a whole event within itself. I don't want to get too deep into it. That's why I talked about that briefly. Okay? I don't want them fucking with me. I don't want them coming after me because of this video. You know, but... Okay, let me see. The last thing in this video that we're going to talk about is New Year's resolution. A friend once asked me, what's your New Year's resolution? For 2021, Mine's is, well, I mean, I said, I want to get my own place. I want to get me a car. I want to get a better job, make some more money, you know what I'm saying? And just be happy. Just find happiness, and whatever that may be. No fake friends. One more time. No fake friends. So what you guys got going on? What's your New Year's resolution? Comment down below and tell me what your New Year's resolution is. Okay. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. You know, it wasn't as long as I thought it was going to be, though. It was actually kind of short. Okay, but, you know, it's, I didn't want to take up too much time, you know, just got straight to the point with this one, you know what I'm saying? But, yeah. Happy New Year's, everybody. The ball gonna drop tomorrow. Everybody yell out Jumanji, okay? And I hope y'all enjoyed this video. It was like, my friend was like, so, what you doing for the New Year's? Stay in my black ass home? The hell, I ain't going nowhere. The hell, I ain't got nowhere to go. Stay in my black ass home. Got my drink and my two-step, no. I got my drink. Whatever that may be, absolute cranberry, or maybe some thigh juice, you know what I'm saying? And then, when the ball drop, wake up in the morning, watching The Honeymooners. Marathon The Honeymooners. I love The Honeymooners. That's what's up. Okay. All right, y'all. That's it. Happy New Year's. Love you. Bye.